The Lehigh University Art Galleries are a collection of over 15,000 works of art of diverse media from all different time periods and cultures. We're a place that celebrates creativity and a place where you can understand diverse perspectives from other people.
So, Will, we're in front of some pop art, some works of pop art.
Exactly. We're here in the galleries with a wall of art that comes from the pop era, including one by Andy Warhol, who really became known for being fascinated with celebrity, looking at icons, people that we might see in movies and on television, including people like Ingrid Bergman.
And this is her.
It is her shown as a nun. But Warhol has really dropped out a lot of the detail that might be in a traditional photograph, and instead is using silk screening and bright, striking colors to really help us fixate ourselves on this strong image.
Right, and maybe perhaps some of these features that he brings out with such prominence are things that struck him.
Yeah, absolutely. Andy Warhol was very interested in the process of being an artist and what that meant.
Right, and this is probably from, I think she was in The Bells of St. Mary.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, and this is a print that's a little bit later from Andy's career. This is from 1983. We have a wide range of sculptures, everything from masks and ceremonial objects from West Africa.
So these are our spirit boards from New Guinea.
Exactly. These are spirit boards made by different cultures living in New Guinea, and they're carved from wood.
And did the folks in New Guinea believe that these help facilitate the presence of their ancestors?
Yeah, absolutely. They thought that these boards actually embodied the spirits of their ancestors. Mm-hmm. So when you look closely at them, you might see human forms, eyes, faces. Mm-hmm. So they would keep them present in the ceremonial houses that they had, or some of the smaller ones they might even carry with them on certain occasions.
Right. Interesting. Now, this is impressionistic art.
Absolutely. This is a painting by the artist Alfred Sisley, who was working in France and often would work outside to really use paint as a way to capture light and how light enters our eyes and really creates a dynamic scene. So this is a scene of a bridge in a town in France.
Mm-hmm. And one other thing about Impressionism is that the brush strokes are very prominent.
Yeah, absolutely. When you look at it, you can see the thickness of the paint. It's almost like type of icing on a cake in some ways.
Supposedly, Monet is the father of Impressionism?
He is. Monet is considered the father of Impressionism, but it was not very well received when it was first exhibited. And in fact, the reviews were pretty negative about Impressionism.
Well, it's amazing how things change.
Absolutely. This is one of our main galleries around campus, and it's often where we have projects either by a single artist or selections from our permanent collection, which we have on view right now. And these are all works that come from our collection and are used as a teaching resource here at the university and the community at large.